Hey guys, this is Alachia, and I don't normally do teasers or reviews of teasers because I kind of hate teasers, especially teasers to the trailer. But this series of teasers for Ghost in the Shell actually did kind of reveal a lot of where I think that the feeling of the movie might be going. And so I just thought I would give a couple comments on it and kind of the direction that I really hope that the movie's going in, and some things that I noticed that did concern me, but things that I did like about it. So for the things that I really did enjoy was the kind of quietness, the tone of the movie. It has a very dark feeling to it, kind of like Dark City. I like that grittiness, that really the dark tones that they're using in the movie, and the kind of quiet nature of it, and a kind of artistic sense, especially that's an artistic sense that means that they're kind of paying attention to the anime quality of the film, or the inspiration from the original story. Now, Scarlett Johansson still isn't selling me, you know, from these teasers. She doesn't have this really awesome glassy-eyed look that, you know, the major tends to have. And that's my really concern, is that she looks too human, right? And she doesn't seem like she has a sense that she is, you know, just a ghost in the shell, and that she has a cybernetic body. And there are moments, especially within the anime series and the movies, that she gives this look, and it's this blue-eyed, glassy look where you can tell for a second that she is cybernetic, right? And so that concerns me that I don't see that. The wig dar is going off like crazy, of course. I hate the wig, but that's just something I'm going to have to personally get over. But, you know, the little geisha scene, I mean, those are intriguing to me, and I think that that's a good start, right? And of course, though, what is ultimately going to be the hugest question, I think, more so than whitewashing and all that stuff, is are they going to get the ghost right? Are they going to tackle the most interesting part of Ghost in the Shell, which is that idea of that existence within anything that gives something life, that gives something special to an entity, so much so that, you know, despite being fully cybernetic, they still value, you know, life within the body because of the ghost, because of, you know, what is here, the soul of a person. That's something that Ghost in the Shell does so well in sort of relaying, and it's a very cool idea that is almost rarely ever, you know, talked about in terms of like what makes something a person? What makes something valuable in terms of existence? Not an expendable piece of machine, right? And I don't really see that quite yet, you know, but these are just really short teasers. So, but that is, you know, basically my main concern. I hope that we kind of see that in the trailer when they finally release it. But so far, you know, I'm still kind of giving it a shot. I think if people are looking to see a great recreation of the movie, they're going to be very disappointed in the original movie anime. I think they're going to be going off of more of the series and some of the storylines from the series. And so, again, what ultimately we have to sort of value here is whether or not they actually get the essence of, you know, the storyline done very well. And that remains to be seen. The teasers, they don't show anything yet, so we don't know. But so far, I think that the look and the feel of it does give me a little bit of hope. I'm still not convinced of Scarlett Johansson as the major character. But, you know, I keep wanting to give it a shot because, you know, I love the anime so much. And I don't know. I really hope they don't fuck it up. Anyways, let me know what you guys thought about the teaser down below and what you think about the casting choice. And of course, ultimately, if you think they can pull off this story. So thanks again for watching, guys. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my Deepwater Horizon review, or you can click right here and watch my Magnificent Seven review. Until next time, see you on the flip side.